In today's video, I want to talk about the lost art of minding your business, aka focusing on yourself. Going after what you want in life, breaking toxic behavioral patterns, creating real change starts when you start focusing on you. In fact, it's a pretty good indication that someone is absolutely not focusing on themselves at all when they're spending most of their time and energy paying attention to what you do. And this energy can be positive or negative. Honestly, it's just as destructive, in my opinion, to be a stan as it is to be a hater. They may seem like two different things, but it's just a lot of wasted energy made manifest that's hanging out on two different ends of the spectrum. It's just people who aren't focusing on themselves. Because let me tell you something. The people who are focusing on themselves, who are taking care of themselves, who are going after what they want, and who are chasing their dreams and their goals and going after bags are way too busy to be worrying about whether Jessica from HR has lost the baby weight or not. If I had to condense this video down into one sentence and you could just leave, don't leave, but it would be, mind the business that pays you. It's that simple. But before you get into, well, excuse me for not wanting to be selfish and only thinking about myself, blah, blah, blah. I'm gonna share 2 points with you at the top of the video that may be helpful to keep in mind. Number one, I am not in the business of extremes. Focusing on yourself does not give you carte blanche to mistreat, ignore, neglect, or be rude to other people and their needs and their feelings. If you have decided that focusing on yourself, that's what focusing on yourself means, then that just tells me that you have an unhealthy relationship with boundaries and yourself. Don't put that evil on me, Ricky Bobby. Number two, I started the high maintenance series that this video is currently a part of because I wanted to push back against this toxic narrative, this screwed up idea that we can't focus on ourselves or make moves for ourselves, or it's selfish or conceited or self-involved or high maintenance. In reality, spending all of your time and energy focusing on other people empties your cup in a lot of ways, serves to keep you somewhere in life you probably aren't happy being, and it also keeps a lot of other people winning because you're not even getting in the game. So please only watch this if you actually want to grow and improve. I know we are all inherently worthy and special and da 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 da. I shouldn't have to clarify that for everyone, but I'm just not in the business. I am not interested in staying exactly where I am in life until the day I die. This isn't the channel for you if that's what you're trying to do. See you later, alligator. Before we get started, make sure you check the down bar for links to all my social media platforms. Thumbs up the video if you do it. Subscribe if you are new here. You know you want to. If you are not new here, hey, what's up? How's your mom and him? Come hang out on Patreon for the book club and bonus content. And yeah, let's just get started. So first of all, what does it mean to focus on yourself? I can't really speak for anybody else or anybody else's experience, but as someone who does YouTube and has for a while, I become very aware all the time of people who are fixating entirely too much on me. And that's just in the parasocial sense. In real life, I also know that I am living rent-free in some people's head all the time. And the reasons for either group of people really isn't the issue or the problem, but the fact is that they're putting their energy towards me. Someone they either don't know at all, don't know anymore, never met before, never will meet. I'm just a person. And they spend their time thinking about me, worrying about me, writing about me, mad about me, hate watching me. It's not a lot of people, like, don't get me wrong, but they're out there. And I'm more using them as an example anyway, so stay with me. Because the fact is, you all probably have people, no matter where you are in life, no matter what you're doing in life, you guys all probably know people who are doing the same thing towards you. Or maybe you are very aware that you're doing this. You're doing this to other people, be it a fictitious character on a TV series or an influencer on Instagram or some girl you used to sit behind in 10th grade. The point is, focusing on yourself is the exact opposite of this. In 2021, I think it's safe to say we are almost conditioned to focus on other people. It's a byproduct of having a window to other people's lives in our pockets at all times. But just because we have normalized something does not make it healthy. And the fact is, this behavior actually starts really young, like middle school and high school, because what else do you have to do all day at school but talk about what everybody else is doing all the time? And that kind of makes sense, because when we're young like that, we're immature. We don't have the emotional wherewithal to kind of look around and realize that our peers are just normal human beings just like us, trying to make their way through this life. And the fact is that some people will never come to that realization. Some people will never grow out of that. So this can manifest in many different ways, but let's just kind of use a smaller example and talk about like drama community and the hate trains and the stands and these regular folks who get so invested in what influencers are doing. Not politicians, not even actors and actresses, just other normal people like them who happen to have a lot of followers. They follow the drama. They're buying their products. They're hanging out in the comment sections. They're wearing the merch, which I get, like, have a hobby to some degree, it's fine. I used to kind of get involved in this kind of stuff too, to an extent, but I think the difference is, once people start getting mad, like big mad, and you can tell which people are actually getting emotionally invested in the actions and choices of another person, that's when I would say it starts to become really counterproductive. And the funny thing about it is, for all the anger these people get around this situation, it's only funny, because what happens is the drama community makes more money, the influencer gets more money attention, and all you've done is ruin your day. Whitney, I can watch a drama video without it ruining my day. Oh, can you? Look, I can't make this case for every single person in every single situation, but I can tell you this. You can be so used to drama, to stress, to dysfunctional stuff, that you're not even aware that you have now made it your hobby. I used to do this. I've actually spoken about it recently. I did it more with like horror, anytime I have to say that word, I hate it. True crime, anything bleak or depressing, because that was the energy I already had inherently within me. It was what I was used to. So I just sought it out in other places. It didn't feel good, which kind of brings me to my next point. I would really encourage you guys to pay a lot more attention to how things are making you feel. I am really focusing as hard as I can on like getting in my body and paying really close attention to how things make me feel, because I'm a naturally very analytical person. I can think my way into and out of anything at any given time. And that's a strength in a lot of ways, and it's helpful in some capacities. But in other ones, it really wasn't allowing me to pay attention to what the things I was involving myself in, what are they making me actually feel like? And the truth is, it didn't feel good. I never walked away from a trash TV binge or a true crime show or a drama video or a negative interaction with somebody else and felt energized, felt good about it. It wasn't like, I just had a fight with my sister, gonna go run a 5K, feeling great. Like, those things don't tend to like meet in the middle somewhere. You know, people aren't fueling their dreams with disdain and negative energy. I mean, maybe if you're a sociopath, but I'm assuming you're not. So first of all, we need to take some responsibility for our actions and really be able to identify when you are putting yourself somewhere you don't need to be, somewhere you have no business being, somewhere you don't even belong, or even better, when you are using that negativity and that judgment to insulate yourself from your own shortcomings and your own screw-ups. It feels really good to focus on other people a lot of the time, because that's the time we do not have to spend looking at ourselves and what we need to do. Which brings me to my next point. Stop running from yourself. When you stop and think about it, the human experience is kind of weird. So we can see other people, we interact with them, we can watch how they handle things, how they make their choices, and how they choose to live their lives, because it's right here in front of us. And unless we are like actually looking at a mirror, it sometimes is almost difficult to even really be aware of ourselves. And unless we are making an active choice to do so, we can move through life completely unaware, not paying any attention to how we handle things, how we are making choices and why we're making these choices and how those choices are affecting our life as a whole. It's kind of how some people can hear themselves on a voice recording and be like, that's how I sound. I haven't had this in a long time. I've made peace with how I sound a long time ago. But you listen to the sound of your voice all day, every day. It's how you know you're speaking. But until it's reflected back to you, you can't really hear it. You need to ask yourself if you're moving through life this way. If you are binging Real Housewives every weekend and scrolling Instagram for hours at a time and gossiping with your friends about so-and-so and who, that is just intentional and repetitive focusing on other people. In the span of 1 week, that is hours of your life, which you don't get back, by the way, this is not a dress rehearsal. Hours of your life given over to someone else's. You guys ever have someone in your life who just hates you? Every move you make offends them to their core, like you just cannot win for losing those type of people. The best part is when it's people who have like never actually met you or interacted with you. I've had that happen to me a couple of times in my life, but even if it's someone you were once really close with and you fell out with them, the fact that this person is focused on you, they think they're doing something, like somehow it's productive, I guess, or somehow that energy they're expending is harming you in some way. I mean, they must, right? They must be getting something out of it. People don't tend to do things that aren't working for them somehow. Yeah, they're getting something out of it. They get to run from themselves in that moment. They don't want to spend time on themselves. They don't want to go after what they want. They don't want to face the music of their own lives. They don't want to put forth any energy to themselves. And it's actually kind of sad because maybe they've convinced themselves that no matter what they do, they can't change anything. Or maybe they don't think they deserve it. Again, it's kind of sad. And like it or not, every single time you get into a fight with a total stranger on the internet or spend your last $40 on some eyeshadow palette that an influencer put out, you're kind of doing the exact same thing. You are putting someone else and someone else's needs ahead of yours and ignoring your own. I think some people have made this a way of life for so long. They might not even know how to do anything else or that there even is anything else. So I want to talk about the difference between the audience and the stage. The fact is, our whole lives, we have been interacting with one of two types of people, and we ourselves are one of two types of people, actually. You are either on the stage or you're in the audience. And to be clear, the stage in this metaphor is not defined by actually having to be on a stage. You don't have to be a performer. You don't have to be on social media with hundreds of thousands of followers to be a person on the stage. Unless that's what you want to do, of course. The people on the stage are the doers of the world. They see what they want and they go after it, whatever it is. Maybe you have always wanted to learn how to garden or draw or learn a new language or play an instrument. You don't ever have to do any of these things in front of another person to be on the stage. It's just that the person on the stage is doing. So we'll say gardening. If you spend 2 hours in your garden loving the process of planting flowers, that's 2 hours you are not spending watching other people doing what they love to do. Those 2 hours are going to go by either way. You can choose to spend it in action, focusing on yourself, giving yourself the gift of fresh air and sunshine, creating something, and then you get to roll up to your house all spring and summer and see a beautiful garden in your front yard. It's why I laugh at the hateful and negative comments on my social media. I didn't always. I really didn't. Now I do, and I audibly laugh. Sometimes I'll share them on Instagram stories so you guys can laugh with me, because I can tell that the person who is leaving these comments thinks they're doing something real big in this moment. And that's exactly why it's funny, because I'm doing something big. I wanted a YouTube channel ever since 2007 when I found my first video. I knew it was what I wanted to do, and I'm doing it. It doesn't matter if I have 100 subscribers or 1,000 subscribers or 100,000 subscribers. The fact is I'm doing it. I get to live my life and do what I love to do. And tons of people will never be able to say that. And I'm willing to bet, I would bet anything, that the exact people who will never get to say that are the types of people who leave hate comments. Because that's what people in the audience do. They would rather zone out in front of the TV watching HGTV. I don't know where this garden metaphor is coming from, except I'm so ready for spring and summer. But they would rather sit there for 2 hours and watch somebody else build or plant their garden, complain about how they're doing it and how they would do so much better. Then they'll go sit on Pinterest and pin 200 pictures of their dream garden and never pick up a friggin' shovel. There are millions of people in the audience. It's easy to be in the audience. That's where most people would prefer to live. I'm pretty unaffected by this stuff now for two reasons. Number one, I just know that you're screwing your karma up. You're ruining your own day. You're carrying this negative feeling. You can say it's not, but again, it's probably because you're not focusing on how being angry and hateful makes you feel. It doesn't actually feel good. But also, like, I don't really take anyone seriously who does this anyway, because anyone who actually has ever created anything, anyone who actually ever has gone after something that they want, who has had a dream, who has showed up and fought for it, they know how hard that actually is, how scary it is. And we're not sitting around judging other people and poo-pooing on what they are doing, because we get it. We know what it's like to be a doer. When I see this type of behavior, and it doesn't even have to be directed at me, I pay attention to anyone who does it, whether it's in my real life or on the internet. I'm very aware of this behavior in people, because when they're doing stuff like that, all I hear, again, they think they're doing something real big. But all I hear in here is someone basically saying, like, I feel small and unseen and invalidated in life, and you don't. And I don't like that. It's the same thing we are taught in kindergarten about bullies. Some people just never grow out of it. They don't want to be uncomfortable and get on stage, but they also don't want to be in the audience either. They hate it and they want to make it your problem. Just do things. I think my friends and family think I'm being hyperbolic when I say, like, I don't have time. I don't have time. I don't have time. And I'm not. I'm just a busybody. If I'm not taking care of my family, taking care of my home, working on something, working out, cooking, then there's a million other things I would rather do than watch other people do stuff. I don't care enough. Like, I'd rather crochet, read a book, draw, garden come spring and summer. You know, I like taking online classes. I'm dabbling with learning another language. I'm crocheting now. I can't remember if I already said that or not. I'm loving it, by the way, in case you're curious. I play board games. Like, there's so many other things I would rather do than worry about what other people are doing. I'm just a busybody. Now, I'm not saying everyone has to be like me or you're automatically in the audience. I just started following what felt good to me. What always feels good to me, for example, is using my hands. I love working with my hands, touching things, creating things. I love planning and visualizing the future. It's why I'm like always up and always, as Leslie Knope would say, jamming on my planner. I love doing it. It feels so good. It gives me confidence. It makes life interesting. It gives me a purpose. I've said this before. If we're blessed, we're going to live to be like 70, 75, 80 and up years old. That's a lot of time. What are you going to do? You're just going to be like, well, I'm good. Everything's good. I'm perfect just the way they am. I'm just going to, you know, get up every day, work 9 to 5, come home, watch Property Brothers, and go to bed every day until I die. Like, okay, you can have it. I personally find audience people super unattractive. I don't respect them. I don't like them. I don't want anything to do with them. They are usually bitter and boring, and they're the same bitter and boring person they were 5 years ago as they will be 5 years from now, unless they decide they want to do and become something different. And it's just that easy. Like I said, not everyone has to be like me. I'm not inherently special in any way. I just make choices. I just take control of the situation. There's so many things in life we have no control over, but we have a lot more than we give ourselves credit for. So I'm going to leave you with this. In moving through your life on a day-to-day basis, I want you to stop and examine your choices. I want you to stop and ask yourself, am I in the audience or am I on stage right now? You don't even have to do anything with that. I just want you to notice it for a little while and then decide, does it actually feel good to keep making the choices that I'm making? Get up here, man. Nothing bad will happen by getting on stage. Actually, all that's going to happen is you'll end up happier with happier people in happier places with more money in your pocket and more purpose in your life. That's all. No big deal. Just food for thought. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you to the Badrons. I filmed two videos today. I've been filming two videos every time I sit down to film. And the other one I filmed today was how to get yourself back after letting yourself go. And I don't necessarily just mean physically. That can be in many different ways. But if you guys haven't seen the new upload, definitely make sure you check it out. And like I said, if you are new here, you want more content like this, and want to go along with our 90, I think it's going to be a 90-day glow up. I started off with a 60-day, but because I need a head start so that I can create content for you guys around this, I'm thinking about pushing it to a 90-day. You guys said you wanted me to make content about it, do something with you guys. And I love interacting with you guys. And honestly, creating community around shared goals is like, yes, I love it. So much fun. So anyway, I hope you guys are having an amazing day. Check the down bar for links to all my social media platforms. And I will catch you in the next one. Bye.